10 in that leading pack, 8 qualifying places for sure. The qualifying, the first 8 from the 2 semi-finals, plus the 4 fastest losers. I think we've said once or twice how quickly the Chinese are developing as an athletics nation, track and field in particular. I mean, they've been dominant in gymnastics and one or two other sports over the years. Table tennis, but this leader, Wang Xiuting, number 3 in the world this year.
Well, eventually I think they'll dominate distance running because they've made such rapid strides in only about 4 or 5 years, but they've done it sensibly. They've imported coaches from elsewhere in the world. They've taken what they can learn from them. And let's face it, if the Chinese can apply themselves and get just some interest in distance running in China, then the number of people who would be involved would be tremendous. Alan Storey was there for a couple of years, initially setting up the training program. He says it was quite difficult to get them to apply themselves, but once he told them exactly what he wanted them to do, and once he told them exactly why he wanted them to do it, they responded well. And, you know, let's face it, we hadn't heard of Chinese distance runners forever until 3 or 4 years ago, and now we're beginning to read about them. They're beginning to run well in marathons and 10,000 meters, and eventually they'll work their way down. But I must say, David, I'm very impressed with Liz McColgan. I think she's got here and she's done the training in the Nihon Center in Japan. She's come here very well prepared. She looks good, she looks smooth, she's very good in concentration terms. She's watched everything that's gone on, she hasn't let anything bother her, and it's going to be a great final.
Oh, we've got a new leader, Lynn Nelson of America, who won the American trials. Wang Xiuting in second place, and that was a 76-second lap, so they speeded up a little bit. Dears of Portugal third, Sargeau of France in fourth place, Liz McColgan is 5, Jackie Perkins, Australia, in sixth place, just being passed by Matt Vieva. Matsuno is up there too. Lynn Jennings of America, next to the back of that leading pack, and right at the back of the leading 10 is Tinari of Canada. Jane Sheedles now some 40 to 50 meters behind the leading 10, unlikely, to say the least, to qualify. Back with the leaders, they're coming round now with 3 laps to go, and somebody's got to break this up, otherwise it's going to be a hectic dash on the last lap. 10 there, 8 sure to qualify.
Well, 3 laps to go. The only thing that Liz McColgan can lose in this race, because she's going to qualify comfortably, is a psychological defeat against Matt Vieva, because I think if she considers who's in this race, who's going to be a factor in the final, Matt Vieva, the Soviet champion, would be the one. So Liz I'd be surprised if she left it till the last lap, and she's got to do something here to get rid of that field down to 8, but I think she should make a move in about the next lap and a half or so, because she might as well do. She's got plenty of time to recover. This won't have demanded very much from her at all, and when it comes to that psychological game, sometimes you can gain an advantage, and there she's gone. Just as I was speaking, I said she'd probably go. She's got 1,000 meters left. Now, I think what she should do now is stretch it so that when she comes off the track, she thinks to herself, "Go, I felt good in that last 1,000 meters, and that's what I'm going to feel like in the final." Now, I think she should, instead of just towing them around now, I think she should demonstrate what a good distance runner she is, because she really is. Matt Vieva's in the back of the group, and if she went now, she could gain a psychological victory over Matt Vieva, and I know that Matt Vieva is one of the competitors that she's worried about. She's looking up at the scoreboard, and that was clever, because she's looking on the scoreboard, she can see what's happening behind her, and that's good tactic, and it's well used in distance running.
So McColgan in front, Wang Xiuting in second place, Lynn Nelson America is third, and the last 3 laps have been run in 76 seconds each one. Jackie Perkins in that pack, and McMikan is up there of New Zealand. Actually, just looking through there, McColgan stepping it up all the time now, gradually winding up the pace. Tremendous support for the Japanese, Matsuno, who at the moment is in fifth place. And when they come around this time, it will be with one lap to go. And so it's McColgan leading, Wang Xiuting in second place, Sergeant of France is third, Dias of Portugal fourth, fifth place, Matvieva of the Soviet Union, Lynn Nelson six, Matsuno seven, Tenari of Canada eight, and the two are losing touch at the moment are Lynn Jennings and the New Zealander Mike Mikan. It's a 73 second lap, so the pedal has really been pushed down, and McColgan going right away now down the back straight with just over 200 to go. Sargeant in second place, Wang Xiuting is third, Matvieva of the Soviet Union, the Soviet champion, in fourth place. And McColgan looks back and there's no trouble there at all. Accelerated very hard, and this well, she's found a lot of speed this season. So McColgan got a lead, the qualifiers in the second semi-final home, eight short to qualify. Matvieva finishes in second place, Wang Xiuting is third, Sargeant in fourth place, Dias of Portugal five, Lynn Nelson America six, Tenari of Canada seven, Lynn Jennings of America in eighth place, Matsuno is ninth, and Mikey New Zealand 10. In 11th place will be Jane Shields, who must wait to see if she qualifies as one of the four fastest losers from the two semi-finals, but I would have thought that very unlikely indeed, because this is very much slower than the first semi-final, and indeed one suspects that all four of the fastest losers will go through from the first semi-final. The winning time in that one was 31.44. The winning time in this one, 32.11.96, with a last lap for Liz McColgan of 67 seconds. It's Matsuno in trouble, the Japanese girl.
And Liz McColgan went immediately to her aid, and it was a pity that there wasn't somebody to pluck her off the track, because Matsuo was in a little bit of distress right at the end of that race. But fine piece of spirited running. And seeing Jane Shields running well there meant, I think, that she wasn't injured, and she did have a spirited sprint finish.
Actually, Jane Shields was only just outside the best time she'd run, four seconds outside. We made her unofficially about 32.46. But I think she'll be disappointed not to have made the final. Well, more disappointed, I would think, is someone normally who would make the final, Angela.